The scene is about, actually I didn't know which of the results to prepare for you, and have chosen the most recent one, that was about the company's financial state forecasting. And I investigated some whether some recent tools, the modern computational tools, could be used in forecasting the financial indicators of the company. And as the subject of my study is Kazakhstani companies, their competitiveness, and our industrial companies, first of all, as an economist, I started from this financial state of these companies. I'm sure that anyone knows that financial state is essential actually for any company, and despite all the social factors, social effects, any company thinks about the profit maximization, and the profitability is crucial. So here we considered, actually me and my co-authors, we considered what kind of modern tools could be used in effective financial planning at any company. And we developed this technique. It consists of four steps. First of all, of course, data collection and processing. The second is modeling the financial state indicators. Then, of course, any model should be verified, tested. And the last one is computing the predicted values. What I want to say that this technique can be used not just to financial indicators. It can be used to any indicators, any time series that you use in your economic analysis. Even it can be applied to indicators like GDP or I don't know, inflation or some other macroeconomic indicators even. But the tool is essential, and let me introduce this instrument. So what we do, this is kind of algorithm, maybe not the best one, but as I am not IT specialist, I try to develop this process during this flowchart. First of all, we have some data at the beginning, and these are indicators that you collect, for example, from some period of time that is available. And of course, the more data, the better the model that you do, actually. In this case, the data is indicators, those stated in financial reports of the company, like balance sheet, and a report on profit and losses. So we can take the indicators, like what indicators could be, like assets, total assets, fixed assets, current assets, can be current liabilities, long-term liabilities, equity of the company, sales, total sales, cost of goods sold, or COGS as we name, and many, many indicators. Then we should define what is the level of, is this series stationary or integrated. So from us, it is easy to do. Actually, it doesn't mean that you should do something by your hand, compute something using calculators. No, it's just you collect this data like Excel spreadsheet with different indicators, quarterly or monthly or yearly collected, and then you import everything into the software. The software that I used is eViews. It is kind of SPSS or Stata, you know, some statistical software. And then when we identify this order of integration, we can divide them to two types. These are stationary series and integrated ones. So if we have stationary series, the one thing that we can do is to make models of regression or autoregressive models, or ARMA, that means autoregressive and moving average models, yes. And we can try to do the good models, testing them by their R-squared, t-statistics or Fisher statistics, And then if the model is good, we can make back testing and accept this model. Otherwise, we should try to build other models. And another thing is if the series are integrated, we should first of all identify which is the order. Is it first order, second order of integration? And if it is, actually the high level of integration is rarely observed thing. And mostly economic indicators are of the first order integration. They are not stationary. Not all of you are economists here, and let me just a little bit on fingers explain what means stationary or integrated. For example, if we look at stochastic processes, like if we have a cube with 1, 2, and 3 up to 6 points on this, yes? Like not this, right? When you drop this, it can be from 1 to 6, yes, any side can you can obtain. This we cannot know, it can be any number from 1 to 6, it can be 5, it can be 3, and after 3 we don't know what will be, 1 or 6, but we have integrated process like temperature side, yes, and if you look at the temperature, if today, if yesterday it was approximately, I don't know, 2 degrees of Celsius, today it won't be minus 50. Yes, it's not stochastic, it's somehow related to its past value. So this series, we can say that there are some kind of integrated time series, and we can try to forecast them more accurately. So that's why. And economic indicators like GDP or inflation, they are not randomly, it's not stochastic process actually, and we can try to forecast what will be in the recent future, the near future, yes? For example, what would be next year or 2 years from now, not maybe but for 10 years because it's a long time, but for some recent future we can try to forecast and use this in addition to our analysis and consider whether we are doing things right and what is the trend, where are we going, how are we developing now. So if they are integrated, we do we get the series with the same integration order, and then build these vector error correction models or auto-regression integrated moving average models, and also can obtain these models and make the back testing also. So let me, if we consider the case of these companies, first of all, there are two kind of indicators. There are some indicators, you know, in balance, within this balance sheet, just because some indicators should be, the values should be balanced, like liabilities and equity should equal to total assets. So we can use this balance method by balancing. We can forecast current assets, operational income, net income, long-term liabilities, and working capital. But to forecast this, first of all, we should find the values, the future values for other indicators like assets, equities, EBIT, earnings before income, interest and taxes, COGS, cost of goods sold, cash, inventory, and so on. So when we have this data, for microeconomic level, actually it was substantiated and proved. The evidence shows that 8-10 years data is enough actually, because it is one business cycle, and for the company indicators it is actually enough to forecast. But what about macroeconomic indicators? Of course it should be one period, I guess, in the past. First of all, we collect the data and check for the presence of seasonality, if this can be. In companies, we have quarterly data, you know, and some quarters can be, like for oil companies, it can be maybe in the third quarter would be high profitable or something like that. So, or if it is agriculture or other companies, those are subject to seasonality. And the data are adjusted from the stationary stochastic seasonality to deterministic seasonality using this tool. And it is also, you do not need to do this tool by your hand. The software allows you just to check to press the ribbon, and it makes everything. Yes, you should just know the algorithm step by step. What should you do with this data? The second is modeling, and we check this time series whether they are stationary with this augmented decoupler, one of the tools, a very nice one. And depending on the results of the test, divide series into stationary and integrated ones. Then, as I said, this integrated series determine order of integration, and we group them. And then we build the model, and then we should verify. When we have this model, what I name model in economy, it's like a function. So you have the indicator, like y or y, that is depending on some other factors. I know that I worked somehow with GDP values, and it depends on something like consumption, investment, and you can make this your axis, x1, x2, the factors influencing this endogenous variable like GDP, and you can try to make a function how GDP depends on other access these other variables. So here also another problem: when you do the structure model, you try just to analyze by how much one factor influences to another. But in the case of forecasting, this is useless models. Why? Because you don't know what would be the value of your x in the future. Yes, it should be in one time. So what is good is it's autoregressive model. What it means, when you try to understand by how much your value in future depends on the past value of this. So these econometric models, the recent ones, those named vector error correction models, they allow us to forecast future values enough accurate actually. And backtesting is when you take not the recent value in the past. For example, you can take the last value, not 2017, if the data is available now, but take the data, the last one for 2016, and then forecast the value for 2017, and then compare, does your model work good? So that means you get the predicted value and compare with the actual value that it was actually, because now you know what is the value of GDP in 2017, for example. You compare, if this deviation is acceptable for you, you can say that your model is good, and then you can predict the value for 2018, for example, that is not available now. So this will mean backtesting, and the backtesting was also done. And the last one, the simple thing is just to compute these predicted values and obtain the data that we want to have. And of course, this method was applied by us, and we made this on the data of Kazumegas. Actually, you know, my theme of thesis, PhD dissertation, was devoted to the financial stability of oil companies, and particularly Kazumegas. And in 2010, when I chose my thesis theme, most of scientists laughed at me because they said this is the most financial stable companies, national company, and the most profitable one. Is there any topicality or sense to study their financial stability? But it took 5 years for me to make my thesis. And in 2015, when I defended my thesis, most of scientists, you know, in 2014, it was the decrease in oil price. And in 2015, it was the most topical maybe thing when I defended, and I was lucky maybe, I don't know. But oil companies not lucky in this case. And actually, it was the problem, their financial stability. So, and forecasting methods are essential in this. When we implemented the research results, showed us that The baseline means these are calculated data. I forecast it and I try to compare with the actual value. So you see, in many of the items, the deviation is not much, but the things like there is current liabilities or accounts receivable, they are less, here this tool doesn't work actually, because the accounts receivable or the current liabilities of the company depends actually not maybe mainly on the company itself, but depends on its customers, and it depends on the conditions in the trade agreement. So in how many days they should pay for this oil that was supplied by this company and so on. But for the indicators like here sales, you see, or equity or assets, actually it is it works, this model works, and it's feasible. We can use this data and work with this in financial planning of the company and trying to, when we have the data, the simple way is to analyze using financial analysis tools like calculating ratios, profitability ratio, liquidity ratio, so we can try to understand where are we going to, what is the direction of development of the company. And if we consider why we took this Kazmunay Gas, we looked at the export structure of Kazakhstan and what about it's actually, I'm sorry, it's not export structure. What about export of Kazakhstan? It was declining in 2015 and 16 in USD. And of course, it also related to devaluation in 2015 and so on. And as we know, if we consider the export structure, the most part of this, the bulk part, is about mineral resources. And as it is very important for us to earn, I mean for Kazakhstan, and what is the items on which we earn money, it is the mineral resources still. So despite all our attempts to diversify our economy, this oil and gas sector is still crucial for our economy, and the Kazmunay Gas is the only national oil and gas company which produces 25% of all oil production in Kazakhstan. Its financial state, I think, is crucial, it's very important, and we should develop all the techniques somehow to plan appropriately the activity of this company. And it is about many, many people employed in this company. And now, if we consider the recent data, I couldn't analyze, I didn't have time, I'm sorry, but I looked through that the profitability of Kazmunay Gas decreased during these recent years, and even inventories decreased. So Kazmunay Gas now mostly tries to earn money on the financial security somehow in order not to fire off all their employees and somehow pay them salary and so on. So I think it will be, this topic of the financial state of this company will be in our agenda in the future still. So some conclusion that this economic efficiency of national companies is possible with timely adequate analysis, and I don't think that this is actually under question. It's no doubt that it should be efficient or adequate analysis, and the management should be proactive, not about what was in the past and we should do something. It should be proactive, and if it is the company, the national company, where many thousands of population are employed, they should be more responsible in their planning. And the recent economic effects are useful in analyzing and forecasting the performance of the company. And I think that all these research results of mathematicians around the world, we should use if these techniques are best, the best one, cutting edge now, these days. We shouldn't be like economists those using some very old techniques like calculating arithmetic or something like that. If we have these models, the complex one, and we developed the softwares in order to make easy to use this, we shouldn't know all the algorithms and calculate by ourselves. Software does this, and why not use these tools in order to get these numerical values to substantiate our theoretical propositions for inferences that we do in our research. Actually, that is all. Thank you. And if you have some questions, maybe about me, my study, or some research results, I am grateful. I want to try to answer your questions.
Thank you.